Well, hi again, you guys. Welcome to another edition of Curtis Collects Vinyl Records. And we are going to talk about, instead of one particular artist, we are going to talk today about some of the great records that are turning 50 years old this year. Yes, 50. So that year was 1971, and this is 2021. So do the math. There is an unbelievable amount of just phenomenal music that was produced and released on the great vinyl format in 1971. And it's hard to make a list. I mean, you can make a list, but then you could throw them all up and have them come down in any order. And there'd be about two or three at the very, very top in my book, but the rest are all sort of tied for fourth place. They're all so, so great. And I have most of them because that's really the sweet spot, 1971, for this great format, vinyl. So before we play the song I picked out that I just adore from 1971, of course it's put out by the Temptations, we'll get to that in a minute. So let's go through some of these, and this is just like the tip of the iceberg. 1971 in probably no particular order until we get to the end. So Rod Stewart had kind of just left Faces. In fact, most of Faces, the guys, Ronnie Wood, Ian McClagan, Kenny Jones, most of the guys on Faces come out and play on this great record. Every picture tells a story. The title song, it was something I could have picked out. It's so solid. What a great, epic song that is. Every picture tells a story. And I have this beautiful fold-out. All right, where are you, Rod? Look at this thing. This is just a fabulous example of what an album cover really could be and what is. I mean, that's just phenomenal. That is absolutely, with all the different like movie posters here done up for each of the songs, I could talk and go on about this for quite some time. So, Santana's third record. I didn't really see anything on here. I think his first two had some songs that were much more significant for me, but he had like three-fifths of Journey on here. Michael Shreve, Neil Sean, and the great keyboard player, it'll come to me, plays with Ringo, not Ross Valerie. Oh, come on. Oh, Greg Rowley. Yeah, that's him. Greg Rowley. It was. Okay, stand corrected. So I don't have the moving zipper on this one. I thought I did, but I don't. So, I mean, you could have picked something from, you know, Sticky Fingers, and that would have been fine with me. Can't You Hear Me Knocking? Maybe the best, my favorite Stone song. Well, one of my favorite Stone songs. One of my other favorite Stone songs is the cover version of the one we're going to do here. So 1971 Genesis. They just mentioned that they're going to be coming back on tour, one of the first big acts with a big North American tour starting this fall. So that's great news for everybody who wants to go see live music. Here they are. They came out with Nursery Crime. You still had sort of the intact Genesis with Peter Gabriel, with Steve Hackett. And this predates The Lamb Lies Down. Look at her. Carly Simon comes out with Anticipation. Boy, oh boy. 1971. You could put this at the very top of your list. How poignant today. What's going on? Marvin Gaye. So poignant. Look at that. He's in his rain slicker. That leather rain trench coat style thing. I think he went over to, instead of making this in Detroit at Motown, I think he went over to Paris and made this record. But it really stands the test of time. The great Marvin Gaye. Wow. Yes. Fragile. This is unbelievable. I mean, this could be on any list. That's terrific. Yep, 1971. Oh, one of my all-time favorites. I've got many, many dozens of his records. Don't be alarmed by the cover here. Herbie Mann. Push, push. This is quite an epic document. This is no joke. This guy was the real deal on Atlantic, and he played so many. He made so many great records. And he does it, it's just not all flute. I mean, that's what he plays, but he really lays out and lets other people take the turn of the spotlight on many, many songs. So if you're just kind of, you know, overdone with just too much flute, you don't really get that too much. But what's significant about this is that Duane Allman plays the last half, the coda of Push Push, the title track, which is a great document for the late, great Duane Allman. Highly recommend this. I could have picked this as my all-time favorite from 1971. Not only is Levon and Tiny Dancer on here, Madman Across the Water, but so many other great songs didn't even make it onto the radio. Indian Sunset, Razorface, Madman Across the Water, the title track. This is Holiday Inn. This is really a great, after Tumbleweed Connection, I think it's my next favorite Elton album. Traffic came out with their funky album cover, The Low Spark of High-Heeled Boys. Here's Cat Stevens coming in with Teaser and Fire Cat, of course. We were playing this the other night upstairs at Happy Hour digitally. It's just a solid document. Jethro Tull comes in, Aqualung. I mean, enough said. That was pretty significant. Paul McCartney, a year or two after the Beatles broke up, comes out and plays everything on every instrument on here on RAM. Produces this up somewhere in his up in his. No, he's got some other guys on here. Hugh McCracken, Denny Sewell. He had some other friends help him out with this. I think he produced this up at his farm up in Scotland. Well, here's the heavyweight champion from the year, 1971 or any year. Led Zeppelin IV, as it's known. I mean, that's just, you know, it could be the greatest album of all time. Any year. And of course, we have to have a double live album. 1971, here they are. This is the gold standard in the format, and according to most people, and I'm one of them. Here they are. The Allman Brothers Band at Fillmore East. I mean, it's just really, it predates Frampton Comes Alive by a full 5 years, and it really was the template from those shows from that era. So let's play this great song by The Temptations. Thank you. Well, thanks again, you guys. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. Thanks for staying patient. I've making a few, not as many of these periodically as I used to, but I think I can get through one a month. And I don't mean get through it, but it's very it's joyful for me to make, and I really enjoy my time in the record room here. And I'm very fortunate to have this facility, and I'm very fortunate to have my audience. Whether you're just popping in and finding this, or you're a longtime subscriber, you can go back, I don't know when the first one I made, maybe 12 years ago. And you can see this, the set changes a little bit, but the concept remains the same. It's all about the format. And don't confuse me with a music expert. I'm not. I am a passionate vinyl record collector. That is that's the goal here. That's what I do. That's what I'm known for. I love this wonderful format that never died and shall remain. So 1971, I think I'm going to do a follow-up on this with a whole 15 other great records to cover, to talk about 1971, because they're all turning 50 this year. So, and I'm 60. So do the math. This was another edition of Curtis Collects Vinyl Records. Really appreciate you guys watching, listening. Thanks for your comments down below. If you want to subscribe, that's cool. That's a huge compliment. So we'll see you guys back here again soon. Thanks.